Well, this book, folks, is the rabbi who found Messiah. And
thank you. Thank you.
Not just a rabbi.
Yeah.
I mean, we had Kurt Schneider here, but this rabbi is the most revered rabbi in recent history in Israel itself, right?
Yes, yes.
Yitzchak is his name?
Yitzchak.
Which is Isaac.
Kaduri.
Yitzchak Kaduri.
Kaduri.
Who lived to be 106 to 108. They weren't quite sure, were they?
Right.
There's a picture of him on the cover.
Yes.
Boy, everybody ought to have this. Christians and Jews need to get this book. Talk about Saul of Tarsus.
Yeah.
And Rabbi Schneider. This man, well, talk about how revered the man has been.
Yes. So this is not just some little obscure rabbi tucked away in the bowels of Jerusalem somewhere, but this guy, I like to call him the Billy Graham of the Jews in Israel. Because this, when Orthodox Jews in Israel see this book and see that picture, immediately they know who he is. In the same way if we had a book with Billy Graham's picture on it, or Pat Boone's picture on it.
Yeah.
Everybody would know who he is.
A little higher than that.
Okay then. Or Shirley Boone's picture of
him. I tell you, it may not be a stretch to say he was almost like the Pope of the Jews.
Well, any of those examples are apropos because...
The leading religious figure.
The note was posted. It was in Hebrew, of course. Israel Today ran a story on it and took a screen capture of the note and put it all over the internet. News First Class, which is a Hebrew-only language big news organization out of Jerusalem, they ran a story on it. The note was kind of encrypted, and he was famous for encrypting his notes, but his note was encrypted with instructions on how to decrypt the note. But you've got to remember now, Orthodox Jew, Orthodox Jewish organization and ministry, so here's this note on the website, but when it was encrypted,
May I interject
decrypted,
just one yes. second? Encrypted means, if people don't know what that means, it's almost like a puzzle, but you're told how to solve the puzzle.
Exactly. In fact, here's what it said. Let me just tell you. I'm going to speak it in English, but in Hebrew it said, "He shall lead his people and prove that the word and the law are valid." Now, that's the sentence he left. Mm-hmm. And people looked at that. Oh, it says concerning the letters of his name.
Uh-huh.
He shall lead his people and prove that the word and law are valid. So when people looked at that, they said, okay, well, that sounds like something about Messiah, but that's not the name. But then they looked at what he said concerning the letter abbreviation of his name, comma, and then the rest of it. The rest of those words, in English it's a bunch of words, but in Hebrew it's only six words.
Mm-hmm.
So they took the first letter of each of those six words, the letter abbreviation, and it's spelled Yehoshua.
Yeah, which is Jesus.
Which is Jesus, which is the Hebrew word, which is the Hebrew word for Yeshua, or Jesus.
Yes.
Now, when they decrypted that and saw that, his organization took the note down. Because, you know, the Orthodox Jewish message basically is based on the foundation that Jesus is not the Messiah.
Mm-hmm.
So when they saw that their Billy Graham said that Jesus is the Messiah, you know, Yehoshua, they took the note down and ultimately destroyed the note. But it had already been screen captured and had been reported upon.
They did destroy the note.
Yes, they did destroy the note.
I've seen the photocopy of it, though.
That's right. And it's in the
book. In his handwriting.
That's right. So, in the meantime, years went by. I was on top of this. My publishers were on top of it, W&D Books, and they asked me, you know, would you write this? We know you know about this story. You've been doing some work and reporting. So I wrote the book. And they've made a movie out of the book. It's a documentary movie.
Oh.
And W&D Films, did award-winning film producer
Great.
George Escobar did it. But the book and the movie have made its way to Israel, and you're not going to believe what's happening in Israel now.
That's what I want to hear about.
Yeah.
Tell me, you
Here's
know.
What's happening. Yes, yes. Yeah. Well, 11 of his students that were in his seminary. Now, when I say students, I'm not talking about 20 and 30-year-old people. I'm talking about 40, 50, 60-year-old men studying to be rabbis.
Yeah.
11 of them now are Jesus, born-again, Jesus-loving, Bible-believing Christians because of the teaching he was doing in his seminary, because of the note being released, and one, just not too long ago, because of reading that book and watching the movie, said, I give my life to Jesus Christ now. Yeah. So, and these are guys training to be Orthodox Jewish rabbis.
We do know, though, that there are a lot of Christians in Israel. We do know that there is an open examination on the part of Jewish scholars. In fact, there's no question to in most Jewish scholars that there was a historic Jesus, that he was a person who lived in Israel in what the beginning of what we call the first century A.D. And discrepancies about what year that actually was, but there was a real Jesus, and they say he epitomized the best of Judaism.
You know, one of the best examples.
And yet he said, I am the Messiah, I am he. So if he was not, that's hardly the best of Judaism.
Exactly. One of the best examples I can give of that truth that you just so beautifully spoke was there's a man in Israel. His name is Zev Peratt, Messiah of Israel Ministries. He's born and raised in Israel. He was born into an Orthodox family, Orthodox Jewish family. His daddy was a rabbi. His grandparents were rabbis. His great-grandfathers were rabbis. He was studying to be a rabbi when he came to Christ by hearing, being on the internet and hearing the gospel and comparing scriptures to scriptures. He gave...
Isaiah 53.
Right.
They don't read Isaiah 53 if they read those scriptures.
Yeah, we've actually read Isaiah 53 to Jewish people, and they were stunned.
They don't know.
They say, well, that sounds like it's about Jesus.
That's right.